Natural gas is a key energy source for the world in general, and for Europe in particular. And it is set to remain so during the energy transition, while evolving through its own decarbonization process. The gas market has a distinctly global character, and in recent years has had to adapt to various circumstances, such as the COVID-19 pandemic or Russia's invasion of Ukraine. The Russian supply cutoff has significantly affected natural gas markets and, to some extent, the way contracts are handled.
And in that regard, we see several new developments, including the resurgence of long-term contracts lasting for 10 plus years. And this is a departure from the earlier trend favoring shorter deals.
In this context, the Naturgy Foundation has released a study that explains how international gas contracts work, prepared by the Oxford Institute for Energy Studies. Gas is traded internationally through gas pipelines or with ships that transport natural gas in liquid form, LNG. Spot contracts and short-term contracts are used mainly as demand adjustment mechanisms. Thus, base supply is traded in long-term contracts, often with durations of 20 or 30 years, known as GSAs for pipeline trading, or LNG SPAs for liquefied natural gas.
Long-term gas and LNG supply contracts involve high stakes, and they are often negotiated by the parties for months on a case-by-case basis. On the substance, they combine various commercial choices of the parties and their shared outlook for market changes.
There is no standard model for these types of contracts, which are also highly confidential. The price is usually the most complex clause to agree on, because there is no single international mechanism to determine it. Normally, formulas are used with a fixed part and another linked to some index or to the price of oil. This pricing mechanism diversity has led to an increasing number of hedges being contracted against market volatility, which affects the costs that buyers and sellers have to face. Other key elements are duration, which must be sufficient to ensure that investments are amortized, or volume, where the priority is for the seller. These contracts also specify the transportation and unloading chain, the quality that the gas must have, or the laws under which the agreement will be governed.
Parties prioritize established laws, offering a strong body of precedence and predictability in the event of a dispute, such as English or New York law. There are certain regional preferences as well, so contracts for deliveries to Europe are often subject to a civil law system, let it be French, Swiss, or Dutch law. Risk allocation is a case-specific decision of the parties. The seller is primarily concerned with the price risk, and the buyer assumes the volume risk, mainly through its take-or-pay obligation. The take-or-pay obligation in essence means that the buyer needs to pay for gas, even if that gas or LNG was not taken. The price risk in essence means that any changes to prices of gas or oil will affect the financial position of the parties.
This type of contract is based on sufficiently long terms to undertake the large investments associated with the gas value chain, but they also incorporate clauses that can respond to large variations in the markets. Thus, the main review mechanism is usually focused on price, detailing what circumstances must be met to start this process, and which tools will be used if the parties do not reach an agreement.
The parties will typically first engage in negotiations and make an attempt to resolve the disputes among themselves without the need to involve any third party. If negotiations fail, then the contract will specify the next, typically more formal step. And this is in most cases recourse to arbitration, where a neutral decision maker, an arbitrator, will render a decision that will be final and binding. Disputes of technical nature, including gas quality or quantification of GHG emissions, are often resolved in expert determination, where an expert or a panel on experts will issue a decision that will be binding on the parties.
These contracts also contemplate the circumstances under which a contract may be interrupted or even terminated. Most of them, apart from mutual agreement, are related to force majeure, and the parties usually try to keep these interruptions as short as possible. One of the biggest demands from buyers to sellers is that they incorporate more flexibility with periodic price review clauses, the possibility to change delivery points if it is necessary to redistribute supply, and the cancellation of some charges that relax take-or-pay contract obligations. In addition, the requirements associated with decarbonisation are gaining ground in these contracts, and the industry is expected to make great strides towards achieving the carbon-neutral emissions target.